Just so everyone's on the same page, sexual consent in Alabama is 16, and you acknowledge that sexual contact with a 14-year-old would have been illegal and would be considered sexual abuse by the books today. But Brandon, you know, you make this argument that there wasn't a law against sexual abuse in Alabama back in the 70s. So I just want to, let me ask, are you saying that because there wouldn't have been a law, according to you, that that would have made it okay back then?
No, I'm not. I mean, if Roy Moore committed a sin, that's a sin and that's not good. But we're not talking about an actual crime here under that's prosecutable in 2017. I don't think you throw out 35 years of a man's career and his reputation because of unsubstantiated allegation from 1979.
Brandon,
that can't be proven
either
way.
She was 14 years of age. And I don't know how much digging you did or didn't do into the law in 1979, but we did. And we found Section 13A, 667. We found that this was on the books going back to 77 and would have been considered sexual abuse in the second degree. Care to respond?
Which is a misdemeanor in Alabama.
Does that make it okay?
If I'm correct.
Yes.
No. But again, if, you know, Roy Moore has stolen a lawnmower when he was 21, that's bad, but that's not a reason 50 years later to all of a sudden, you know, throw him off the ballot or let Mitch McConnell pick the next senator of Alabama.
Sexual abuse, stealing a lawnmower, let's not even go there.